everybody. It's a beautiful day in Portland, Oregon. So what do you want me to do? I have a prepared statement. I'll answer questions. Okay. So first of all, I came here today to express my support for the protesters and occupiers, to thank them for devoting their time and resources to raising awareness about our federal government's unethical and unconstitutional treatment of undocumented immigrants and refugees, of unjust removal and detainment, including of legal residents, and the especially despicable practice of tearing children from their families at our borders. Portland is a sanctuary city, and Oregon is a sanctuary state. That means we have resolved not to cooperate with the federal government's effort to enforce immigration law, but that's not enough. We must also defend our immigrant and refugee communities, and that's what is happening here today, and is happening all over the country. I couldn't be more proud of Portland for this effort. They're giving so many people hope at a time when it's easier to give in to despair. I came down here today in particular because the feds moved on back into the property at 3 a.m. and have asked the protesters to leave, citing that they're violating federal law. Well, in my opinion, our federal government is also violating the law. They're violating our Constitution. The 5th and 14th Amendments are meant to protect everyone, regardless of immigration status, from deprivation of life, liberty, or property without due process of the law. So if the feds want to talk about how these protesters who are exercising their constitutional right to peacefully assemble and protest, how they are breaking federal law, then they can answer to us about what they're doing. I am proud to join Representative Earl Blumenau in calling for the abolition of ICE. I'm pleased to announce that I just heard from his team that he'll be co-introducing a bill with Representatives Mark McConn and Camila Jayapal that seeks to abolish ICE and restructure the way we conduct immigration enforcement. When our federal government is violating individuals' civil, human, and constitutional rights, not sit idly by. If our president truly wants to protect the safety of our families and communities, I suggest you deal with the real threats we're facing. Our national housing crisis, growing income inequality, access to affordable health care, environmental degradation, and a grossly inequitable education system. So I'm joining with these protesters and protesters around the country to call for the end of ICE and to shut it down. It's impressive. I mean, I have no idea how many people have been down here. I'll say the numbers are smaller just because the action was taken by the feds early this morning. I think a lot of people chose to vacate and not return, but there's still a considerable amount.
Is all city council supporting this protest?
I don't know. Members of the protest. There may be people who feel very vulnerable right now, right? If we stand up and fight back. You can do it politely on the sidelines and allowing people to continue with no disruption is going to be an effective protest.
I know.
So what happened to the mayor about
that? Briefly. We actually have to get back to the office. We're certainly on the same page as far as not wanting to get the city involved and not send police. However, the status has obviously changed as of this morning. I have no idea what the mayor's intention is. All I can go on is the statement that we're crossing.
If Homeland Security asks you guys to bring the Portland police.
Thank you.